Wellington polo mogul John Goodman is on trial for DUI manslaughter.
Scott Wilson was killed in 2010, just after graduating from college. Investigators say the man who's responsible for the crash that killed him is millionaire John Goodman. Our Kathleen O'Toole has been in the courtroom all day. She's live in West Palm Beach. Kathleen.
It was a prosecutorial parade of witnesses. And if you'll recall, one of the big defense strategies here is to say that Goodman's Bentley malfunctioned that night. Well, the prosecution put on witness after witness and asked them all the same question. Did Goodman ever tell you that his car malfunctioned? And every last one of them said no.
I got out of the car and called to see if there's anyone around. And then I called 911.
An eerie silence greeted Nicole Oroco, the first known person to witness the wreckage left behind at the Wellington crash scene. John Goodman had left, and Oroco didn't know Scott Wilson was left to drown in his car, upside down in a canal.
You looked into the canal?
Yes.
You didn't see anything in the canal, did you?
No.
It was very dark there, wasn't it?
Yes.
Almost pitch black.
It was dark.
The defense arguing the polo mogul also couldn't see the 23-year-old's car.
I heard a bang on the door. It was loud enough to wake me up.
This woman, horse trainer Lisa Pempleton, knew exactly where Goodman went after the crash, to her trailer down the road, where both sides agree he borrowed a phone not to call police, but to call his girlfriend.
What did he say to this lady?
He said, I really f***ed up.
But he used the word.
Yes.
Okay.
And that he had been in an end of the world accident.
This is that lady, Heather Colby, a stay-at-home mother of two who is Goodman's girlfriend, and in an eyebrow-raising move, also his adopted daughter.
Did he tell you that he had a concussion?
No.
Have you discussed anything with Mr. Goodman about the crash?
No.
And Ellen Roberts, the prosecutor here, also got the girlfriend slash daughter to say that Goodman had never told her that his Bentley malfunctioned, only that he wanted his driver to come and get him. Victor?
Okay, so we saw those three women. Who else was on the stand today?
Well, it was a lot of the officials, kind of the crux of the prosecution's case. We had two deputies, as well as the first responders, the EMS, and then the defense got to cross-examine, as they get to do, and had a lot of questions about how well the deputies were trained in knowing about blood alcohol and alcohol on the breath. And one deputy was questioned repeatedly by the defense about why he didn't go into the canal after Scott Wilson. For now, we're live in downtown West Palm Beach. I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.
All right, Kathleen, thank you. Now, for in-depth coverage of the John Goodman trial, stay with WPBF 25 News and WPBF.com. Every day, we'll have a live video stream inside the courtroom. You can also see all of our previous stories, including why prosecutors were concerned about Goodman's good looks. Just click this story on the homepage.